Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and we have another tutorial on creating animated loaders in PowerPoint 2016. And this animation is a replica of a pen by CamHop at codepen.io. So here we have, let me show you the objects that I have used in this presentation, and for that click on the Home tab, then click Select drop down button and choose Selection Pen. And I have used four objects here. One is YouTube logo, and next is the text which I have written here, live stream. And next two are not actually the text, they are objects in the slide. And I have converted these rounded corner rectangles and their text into an object, and I will show you that how I did this in this tutorial. And another thing is, go to the animations tab and then click on animation pen. And here you can see that I have used only two animations here, which are motion paths. So let's get started. And first of all, click on the file menu, then click close, and then click file, new, blank presentation. Collapse the thumbnail view, go to the home tab, and then click layout, choose blank. Here I will draw the rounded corner rectangle first. And for that, go to the insert tab, click shapes, and then choose rounded corner rectangle. Just click inside the slide, and here you can adjust the size, and I need a height of 0.25 and the width of 1.25. and for zoom in, you can use this zoom slider, or you can hold down the control key and then use the middle mouse button to zoom in or zoom out. Change the shape by holding the yellow handler here. Now go to the shape outline and choose no outline, and then adjust this rectangle in the center of the slide and in the middle of the slide as well. Now change the position by holding the shift key and then hold down the rectangle right from here, and then just move. By holding the shift key, it will move the objects into straight line. That is why I hold down the shift key. The next thing is typing the text, and for that go to the insert tab, click word art and choose a style, and type your text, then select the rectangle, text rectangle, go to the home tab and decrease the size. Okay, now hold down it and move it right here, I think a little bit. If you want to increase the spacing between the characters, then you can go to the font dialog box and go to character spacing, and here you can increase the width between the characters by giving the value in points. Like, let me add this to 10 points and hit the OK button, and you can see the changes here. Go to the font dialog box again, and I think 4 will be enough. Yes. Now, as I have selected the text, hold down the shift key and then also select the rectangle. Go to the format tab, click the align drop down button, and you can see that by default it is selected align selected objects. And that means if I now choose align center and align middle command, then the text will get aligned to the rectangle. Okay, now select the rectangle, hold down the shift key and then click on the loading text, and go to the format tab, click merge shapes drop down button and choose subtract. And that will convert this text and shape into one single object. And you can see that in selection pen here, right here. And let me rename it to blue loading. Now you need to duplicate this object. For that, hold down the control and shift key. Move your mouse pointer near to the border and you will see a plus sign with the arrow. Now just drag and drop this object to the right. Adjust the position of the left. The blue color is for this rectangle is fine. I just need to change the transparency level of this color, and for that go to the format tab, click shape fill drop down button and choose more fill colors, and here I will set a transparency level to 10%. Hit the OK button. Now select this rectangle, change the fill color, and I will go with more fill colors. And we'll try to adjust a color matching with magenta, and we'll set a transparency level of 10%. Hit the OK button. Okay, that's fine. Now select the left rectangle, go to the animations, click add animation drop down button, choose more motion paths, and here select the right path, hit the OK button, and adjust the path length. Hold down the shift key while adjusting the path, and that will also move the path to a straight line. Okay, set it to play with previous and a duration of 1 second. Open the animation pan, double click the animation to open the effect options, and make a check mark on auto reverse, and I don't want any smoothness, so I will remove them. Go to the timing tab and set repeat until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. That's fine. Let me rename this to magenta loading instead of blue. Okay. Now select the left rectangle, go to the animations tab, click animation painter, and then click on the right rectangle. And what you only need to do is to go to the effect option and change the position to left, and then adjust the path. Hold down the shift key and just set it right here. Okay, we have our main animation. Let me show you the preview. Okay, we need to set the timings here. Let's see the preview. Okay, we also need to remove the smoothness here. It's up to you that how you want to animate the both of the rectangles, and if you want to add the smoothness, then you can do that. Then we will see that how it will react. Hit the OK button. Okay, little fast. Okay, I think that's fine. Now open internet and type YouTube logo png, hit the enter key, go to images and choose a logo, right click, copy image, go to PowerPoint, go to home tab and then click paste, zoom out and adjust the size. You can hold down the control shift and alt key while adjusting the size, and that will reduce or increase the size simultaneously from all the sides, and just put it right here a little bit short. Okay, insert word art, another text, live stream, select the text, change the font, I will go with DK Jumbo, adjust the size, put it right here, that's fine, change the text color, and for the background, right click on an empty area, go to format background, pull the more color options, choose yellow, then go to custom, and then I think that's fine. Hit the OK button. A little more lighter. So let's see the final preview. And I hope you will find this video informative. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. If you find this video interesting, then don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. You can subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Yeah.